Welcome to Interscalar, the channel that invites you to study the world with fresh eyes. Visiting this channel, you will experience that Interscalar makes science transparent. You will find new answers to many questions concerning the nature of the universe and the meaning of life. Please consider that this video is merely an illustration. It does not claim to be complete. Here we refer to the linked publications. Thank you. Our heart beats one time per second, and we prefer to breathe 15 times per minute. When we are born, we weigh only around 3.5 kilograms. Then most of us grow until 60 kilograms and more. But our brain stops to grow when it reaches 1.5 kilograms. Why is the resting heart rate of healthy adults close to 1 beat per second? Why is the adult human brain mass close to 1.4 kilograms? Why does the hypophysis weigh 500 milligrams? Why is the focal length of the human eye of 16.7 millimeters? Why does the brain activity change from delta to theta at the frequency of 3 hertz? Why does it change again to alpha at the frequency of 8 hertz, from alpha to beta at 14 hertz, and from beta to gamma at 37 hertz? All by chance? Actually, conventional models consider many characteristics of human biophysics as to be accidental. In contrast, interscalar astrobiology considers all the biological organisms on Earth as parts of the solar system and derives their physical characteristics from the system. In this video, we will derive many characteristics of human biophysics from the mathematics of our solar system. Today, we talk about the astrobiological significance of Euler's number. The solar system hosts at least 800,000 orbiting each other bodies, planets, planetoids, and moons, but also many asteroids. How this huge system can be stable? Through the voice of Pythagoras, ancient knowledge is teaching. Number rules the universe. In our first video, The Secret of Euler's Number, we have learned that the difference between integer numbers, rational, irrational, algebraic, and transcendental numbers is not only a mathematical task, but also an essential aspect of stability in complex systems. For instance, integer and rational frequency ratios provide resonance interaction that can destabilize a system. An integer frequency ratio causes a periodic excitation that optimally transfers the energy of one oscillation to another. Because of this repeated energy input, the system swings ever more strongly until its load limit is exceeded and it will be destroyed. With reference to the solar system and its stability, we may therefore expect that the ratio of any two orbital periods should be not rational. Ratios of whole numbers mathematicians call rational numbers. As we already clarified, those ratios provoke destabilizing resonance interaction and therefore we must avoid them. Very different are irrational numbers. They are not ratios of whole numbers, and consequently they should not cause destabilizing resonance. For example, the square root of 2 is irrational. However, irrational numbers like the square root of 2 or other roots do not compellingly prevent resonance, because they transform into whole numbers by multiplication. The square root of 2 multiplied by itself equals 2. Consequently, already if two frequency ratios coincide with square roots, they can provoke destabilizing resonance. Fortunately, there is a type of irrational numbers called transcendental, which are not roots. They do not transform into rational or whole numbers by multiplication, and consequently, they definitely do not provide resonance interaction. Probably the best known transcendental number is pi, but there are infinitely many transcendental numbers. Among them, only Euler's number e fulfills another very important criterion. Euler's number is the basis of the natural exponential function, the only function that is the derivative of itself. The derivative is the rate of change. Why is this so important? Actually, frequencies of real processes are not constant. Therefore, to reach lasting stability, a real system must avoid resonance not only regarding the frequencies, but also regarding their rates of change. Only Euler's number can guarantee this. In this way, Euler's number provides a solution for lasting stability in real systems of any degree of complexity. Probably, Euler's number is the main stabilizer in the universe. In our first video, we have shown how Euler's number stabilizes the solar system. Euler's number and its roots are attractors of transcendental numbers that prevent destabilizing resonance. They form islands of stability, where planets can form and move in stable orbits. Therefore, planets and large planetoids have orbital periods separated by Euler's number and its roots. Finally, in our video, The Secret of the Electron, we have learned why the electron and the proton are so exceptionally stable. The secret of their stability is Euler's number. The transcendence of Euler's number makes impossible proton-electron resonance. In this way, proton and electron can form stable atoms. Actually, the proton-to-electron mass energy and frequency ratio approximates the 7th power of Euler's number and its square root. Here I would like to underline that the standard model in particle physics does not derive the proton-to-electron ratio, but considers the value of this fundamental physical constant as to be accidental. Thanks to Euler's number, the lifespans of the proton and the electron surpass anything that is measurable, exceeding 1,000 billions of billions of billions years. Created by Euler's number, electron and proton act as two eternal metronomes of the universe. Through Euler's number, these metronomes stabilize other cycles in the universe. For instance, the orbital periods of the planets and large planetoids originate from the oscillation periods of the electron and the proton. In fact, if we multiply the electron oscillation period 63 times by Euler's number, we encounter the orbital period of Venus. scaling up the electron oscillation period, multiplying by Euler's number 66 times, we meet the orbital period of Jupiter. And after 69 times scaling up by Euler's number, we meet the orbital period of Pluto. Thanks to Euler's number, every planet avoids not only orbital resonance with other planets, but avoids also parametric resonance with all the electrons and protons a planet consists of. This example shows how Euler's number creates interscalar stability. In this case, the stable embedding of subatomic dynamics into planetary motion. The scale in this graphic is logarithmic and shows the planets and large planetoids in the sequence of their orbital periods. The orbital periods approximate integer powers of Euler's number and its square root relative to the oscillation period of the electron. Here I would like to underline that conventional models of the solar system consider the current orbital periods of the planets and planetoids as to be accidental. On this background, the identification of Euler's number as main stabilizer of the solar system is key knowledge for successful space exploration. Euler scaling stabilizes also biological processes like the brain activity. In our video, The Secret of the Brain Waves, we have shown that Euler's number stabilizes the frequency boundaries of the brain waves delta, theta, alpha, beta, gamma, which indicate different states of brain activity. The scale in the graphic is logarithmic. White numbers indicate frequencies in hertz. In the delta range, in pulses per minute. Scaling up the electron oscillation period multiplying by Euler's number 46 times, we get exactly the theta-alpha boundary. And scaling up 47 times by Euler's number, we get the delta-theta boundary. The transcendence of Euler's number avoids resonance between different states of brain activity, and in this way separates them. The physical separation of different states of brain activity is essential for its stability. The violation of this separation can cause psychic diseases. We are talking not exclusively about human physiology, but about biophysics. For instance, the frequency boundaries of the brain activity ranges theta, alpha, and beta are common for all mammals. Here I would like to underline that conventional neurophysiological models consider the brainwave boundary frequencies as to be accidental. Naturally, also the frequency ranges of our respiration and our heartbeat follow the multiplicative sequence of Euler's number and its square root. This is valid also for the frequency ranges of our muscle vibration and our eye scan rate, or more precisely, the flicker-fusion threshold. Furthermore, similar boundary frequencies we find in the Earth's electromagnetic field spectrum. For example, the fundamental Schumann mode, 7.8 Hz. Solar X-ray bursts can cause variations of the Schumann frequencies. In this case, the fundamental increases up to 8.3 Hz, reaching exactly the stable theta-alpha boundary. The second Schumann mode, 14 Hz, coincides precisely with the alpha-beta boundary. It is remarkable that solar activity affects this mode much less, or does not affect at all, because of its Euler stability. The coincidence of the boundary frequencies of brain activity with Schumann frequencies demonstrates how precisely the electrical activity of biological systems is embedded in the electromagnetic activity of the Earth. Important to know that Euler's number and its roots make possible this embedding, because they are attractors of transcendental numbers and form islands of stability. Mathematicians call the exponent of Euler's number natural logarithm. In this way, every stabilized by Euler's number cycle in the universe has its natural logarithmic address, a kind of cosmic logarithmic mailbox. The electron-based logarithmic address of the theta alpha boundary is 46. As we already know, the fundamental Schumann frequency has the same address. This circumstance makes possible the exchange of information between systems of very different scales, the biophysical and the geophysical. In addition, biophysics is embedded in astrophysics. For instance, the teenage resting respiratory rate, 20-25 breaths per minute, approximates the logarithm 49, relatively to the oscillation period of the electron. Naturally, the logarithm of the corresponding wavelength of light is the same. Surprisingly, 49 is the logarithm of the radius of the photosphere of our Sun. The wavelength of light that corresponds with the adult resting respiratory rate, 12-18 breaths per minute, reaches the radius of the corona of our Sun. The wavelength of light corresponding with the main frequency 5 Hz of theta brain activity coincides with the radius of Saturn. The radii of Uranus and Neptune coincide with the wavelengths of alpha activity. The radii of Venus and Earth coincide with the wavelengths of low gamma activity. The radii of Mercury and Mars approximate the wavelengths of the flicker fusion threshold in the range of high gamma activity. Finally, the radii of Pluto and Eris correspond with the extreme boundary wavelength of the gamma range. What about the heartbeat? The wavelength that corresponds with the adult resting heart rate coincides with the radius of our moon's orbit. What about the beta activity and the muscle rate? The wavelength that corresponds with the main beta frequency, 23 Hz, equals 13,500 kilometers. That is twice the Earth radius. Obviously, there should be still at least one unknown planet in the solar system. In fact, astronomers are searching already for the planet 9 in the outback of the solar system beyond Neptune. I suppose that two similar planets will be discovered, because all known planets form couples. In my opinion, modern medicine should consider the embedding of human biophysics in the astrophysics of our solar system. Our knowledge of the stabilizing significance of Euler's number allows us deriving the majority of physical characteristics of the solar system, including biophysics, directly from the electron or proton. For instance, the current mass of our Sun approximates the 139th power of Euler's number relative to the electron mass. Now, multiplying the electron mass with the square root of the 139th power of Euler's number, we get 1.3 kg. That coincides with the average adult human brain mass. The current mass of the planet Mars approximates the 124th power of Euler's number relative to the electron mass. Attention! Now multiplying the proton mass with the square root of the 124th power of Euler's number, we get 1.4 kg, another approximation of the average adult human brain mass. It differs from 1.3 kg by nearly 10%, like the average male brain mass differs from the average female brain mass. The current mass of our Sun approximates the 131.5 power of Euler's number relative to the proton mass. Now, multiplying the proton mass with the square root of the 131.5 power of Euler's number, we get 60 kilograms. That is the statistically average adult human female body mass. The current mass of the planet Jupiter approximates the 132nd power of Euler's number relative to the electron mass. Now, multiplying the electron mass with the square root of the 132nd power of Euler's number, we get 77 kilograms, that is the average adult human male body mass. Please note that this is not exclusively about human physiology, but about biophysics. In one of our next videos, we will come back to this topic regarding the biophysics of animals, insects, plants, and microorganisms. Euler's number stabilizes the biophysics not only of adult organisms. Let us see some examples. The current mass of Venus approximates the 126th power of Euler's number relative to the electron mass. Now, multiplying the proton mass with the square root of the 126th power of Euler's number, we get 3.8 kilograms, that is the statistically average weight of a newborn. If now we proceed in the same way with the mass of the Earth, we get 4.2 kilograms, that is close to the average weight of a larger newborn. Statistically, baby boys are heavier than baby girls are. It might well be that this difference corresponds with the mass difference between Earth and Venus. Another example. Saturn's radius approximates the 54th power of Euler's number relative to the proton wavelength. Now, multiplying the proton wavelength with the square root of the 54th power of Euler's number, we get the wavelength 0.11 millimeter. That coincides with the size of the human ovum. Saturn's radius approximates also the 46.5 power of Euler's number relative to the Compton wavelength of the electron. Now, multiplying the proton wavelength with the square root of the 46.5 power of Euler's number, we get the wavelength 2.5 micrometers, that coincides with the size of the human sperm. You remember that Saturn's radius approximates the 54th power of Euler's number relative to the proton wavelength. Now, multiplying the proton mass with the 54th power of Euler's number, we get the mass of the pituitary gland, the hypophysis. It is a red point in the center of the skull image. The hypophysis is our master gland, because it controls other hormone glands, the adrenals and the thyroid, and many biological functions, metabolism, growth, sexual activity, pregnancy, childbirth, nursing, blood pressure, temperature regulation, pain relief, and stress response. As we can see, our master gland corresponds with one of the master planets of the solar system. Now let's come back to our Sun. The radius 700,000 kilometers of the photosphere of our Sun approximates the 49th power of Euler's number relative to the Compton wavelength of the electron. Now, multiplying the electron wavelength with the square root of the 49th power of Euler's number, we match exactly the focal length 16.7 millimeters of the human eye. This is also the size of the newborn eyeball. This image gives an overview of some interscalar facts we were talking about. The Sun and the planets determine our biophysical characteristics derived from the electron, letter E, and the proton, letter P, by Euler's number. What could be the meaning of all these remarkable coincidences? All by chance? I don't think so. I propose an astrobiological interpretation. As all the biological organisms on Earth are part of our solar system, stable biophysical characteristics derive from the system via Euler's number. In a similar way, all the biological organisms on an exoplanet are part of their system. Therefore, the biophysical characteristics of alien physiology derive from the astrophysical characteristics of their sun and planets. On this background, the identification of Euler's number as main designer and stabilizer of planetary systems, including the huge diversity of their habitats, is key knowledge for future space exploration. Let us imagine aliens visiting our solar system. Naturally, they know about the stabilizing significance of Euler's number and know the properties of the electron and the proton. In this case, they can derive the biophysics of the majority of species, including human, from the astrophysics of our solar system. Interscalar astrobiology is making its first steps. In future, perhaps we will be able to apply our knowledge in this field for estimating the biophysics of alien species living in the systems of Alpha Centauri, Sirius, Altair or Vega. That's all for today. More information and many examples you can find in my book, global scaling, the fundamentals of interscalar cosmology, you can free download. The link you find below this video. Thanks for watching.